Thank you. Oops. Not my size. So, good afternoon. This is an amazing day to be here, and I'm very proud to serve as the dean for the College of Arts and Sciences, which our Department of Music is part of and such a large part of. I wrote my thoughts down because I've been told my minutes don't equal other people's minutes, so I'm providing myself some structure. On behalf of the College of Arts and Sciences, we'd like to thank everyone for being here to share this wonderful celebration of the vision and the dreams for our university, college, and our music program. First and foremost, we want to thank Dr. Talent for being the amazing advocate that he's been for us. We are grateful for his strong voice and resolute and never giving up, in spite of what he was told in terms of going for a music building, never giving up on our dream and our vision for our music program and his new building. We also want to thank the team of system, university, architects, construction, legislative personnel, everyone who worked so tirelessly in planning and moving this dream forward. Texas A&M University Kingsville has a great tradition of music, not only on campus, but as you've heard other people mention, across South Texas, across the state. Our program has prepared and influenced music education across South Texas. I attended a function last year, a couple years ago, where our music department was recognized by the Rio Grande Music Educators, and I'm sure I'm getting some of that title wrong, but basically it was across the Rio Grande Valley. And so I met a lot of band directors, and they were all our graduates. I asked Paul, are they all from A&M Kingsville? And he said, pretty much, they were all Javelina proud, and they were all our graduates. So we have an influence across this area, this music program has. And the music program is bigger than just our program. It involves all students across campus, staff, faculty, and our community here in Kingsville. It contributes to the cultural and social life of the university and our community. As the mayor said, there is a lot to do on campus, and our music program delivers a lot of that. It is a major part of student and campus life. It delivers and offers a lot of performance experiences, all designed to serve, enhance, and transform the music interests of our campus and our community. This building, most importantly, supports our commitment to our students, providing them here in South Texas with an exemplary education in a state-of-the-art facility. We look forward to seeing the vision being created and built piece by piece out in that corner, and how it's going to transform our campus, our students, and our community. Again, from on behalf of the College of Arts and Sciences, our sincere thanks for your support and for being here today as we kick off this new phase in our music program.
Thank you, everybody. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our official groundbreaking ceremony, an event that we will cherish for a long, long time. We deeply appreciate all of you sharing this occasion with us. But first, I'd like to thank the Javelina Marching Band and their director, Dr. Jason Keeley, for providing the music. Come on. This is a great day for our music program. We've been patiently waiting for this day a lot of years. And I must say, we could not be more excited about what this new facility means for the future of our community, university, program, faculty, and especially our students. One of our goals is to become the premier university music program and resource in the region, and this facility will help us to accomplish that. We will be able to host state, regional, and even national music conferences in our new facility. We can invite guest artists of world renown to perform in our new performance hall. We can host and partner with organizations like the Texas University Interscholastic League, the National Association of Teachers of Singing, and the Texas Music Educators Association to hold competitions, auditions, and tryouts here in our facilities. Our music department will finally have room to grow and expand our programs and course offerings. We can possibly add new programs in recording technology or music business. We can possibly expand our master's degrees to include programs like conducting, jazz studies, opera, musicology, and theory composition. We can even work to one day offer the first doctoral music degree in South Texas. With this facility, Music Factory will be able to teach more efficiently and effectively by having the resources, classrooms, rehearsal and practice spaces, and studios that will enhance their teaching rather than hindering them. And our students will finally have the facilities, resources, and opportunities that they have deserved for so many years. Our alumni and students have endured less than satisfactory circumstances for years, but they have still produced incredible results throughout their hard work and dedication. In the last several years, our students and graduates have accomplished much in several areas, such as our ensembles and students have been invited to perform and present at state, regional, national, and international conferences. Our students and ensembles have placed in competitions and won major awards. Our music graduates have enjoyed a nearly 100% job placement rate. Our music graduates have gained graduate admission to many of the most prestigious graduate music schools in the nation. And our music students have scored a nearly 100% first-time pass rate on the Texas Teacher Certification Exam. These are just a sampling of some of the wonderful accomplishments of our students, but maybe these are only the beginning. The legendary composer and conductor, Richard Strauss, was once paraphrased as saying, "Never look at the trombones, it only encourages them." Well, I think it's safe to say that looking at this new facility, our student musicians will be encouraged for a very long time in ways that none of us have even dreamed of yet. To sum it up, this new facility has created an atmosphere within our music department that can best be conveyed in one sincere emotion: gratitude. We are grateful to all the people who have helped make the dream of this building into a reality, such as Representative J.M. Lozano, Senator Eddie Lucio, and the entire Texas Legislature, Chancellor John Sharp, and the administration and staff of the Texas A&M system, Craig Reynolds and the architects, designers, and engineers at BRW, HGA, Acoustical Distinctions, Shuler Shook, and Spa Glass Construction. And finally, Dr. Stephen Talent and the administration and staff of Texas A&M Kingsville. Dr. Talent has worked tirelessly to help make this building into a reality. Without Dr. Talent and his efforts on our behalf, we would not be here today. Thank you, President Talent. Also, I am grateful to work alongside a fantastic music faculty who work together as a team, who keep the students as the focus of their teaching, who strive for excellence in everything they do, and who selflessly give of their time and talents to further the art of music in the name of music education. I want to thank all of the music faculty for their teamwork, enthusiasm, ideas, and time and effort spent on this project and everything they do for our students. Faculty, would you please stand, music faculty? hand. We, the music faculty, are grateful to work with such a talented and dedicated music student body and alumni. The students have put their trust in us, and we have done our best to deliver on our promise of helping students achieve excellence in their music education. The need for this building stands on the shoulders of every music student who ever squeezed through the halls of our music building to practice, study, and grow as a musician. To everyone involved in this effort, and on behalf of the music faculty, staff, and students, please accept our sincerest appreciation and gratitude for all you have done. This historic event also presents an opportunity for a community of friends and alumni. If you are interested, different performance spaces, classrooms, and event venues are available for philanthropic naming. If this piques your curiosity, please see Hector Lopez or Jeff McClain, and they can share potential spaces to place the name. Would you guys stand up so they see who you are right now? So, in conclusion, to the students and alumni of our music program, it's nearly time to start an exciting new chapter in our history. Your hard work, dedication, and perseverance have paid off. I just want to remind the music faculty, staff, students, and alumni that this building is not something to which we are entitled. Rather, it is something that we have all worked together to earn. And for that, we should all be extremely proud.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to say how incredible it is to see everybody that is gathered here today come together for such a special occasion. Being able to stand here and be a part of this is especially sweet, knowing that this new music building is a long-time dream come true for a lot of people here today. Today's groundbreaking ceremony marks a new beginning, not only for the music department here at Tampa, but for the entire university and the entire Texas A&M University system. However, all this would not be possible without the perseverance, dedication, and vision of President Stephen H. Kallett, Dr. Paul Hageman, the Tampa Music Department faculty, our state legislators, Mr. J.M. Lozano and Mr. Eddie Lucio, and our Texas A&M University System Chancellor, Mr. John Sharp, the architectural and design team, who all helped make the dream of a new music building come true. Please give them another round of applause. A moment ago, I said that today's groundbreaking ceremony marks a new beginning. That is without a doubt true. However, I also strongly believe that this is a milestone in continuing the tradition here in the music department at Tampa. Now you may ask, what is the tradition? I'll tell you. The very first time I learned about the music department here at Tampa, I was in the seventh grade, and my middle school jazz band came to compete at the 39th annual Texas A&M Jazz Festival. In case you're wondering, we just had our 51st annual jazz festival this past March. That day on this very stage, right over here, I played my very first jazz performance, and I can still hum the solo that I played that day. I remember watching Jazz Band 3 perform right before the awards ceremony, led by Mr. James Worth, who is now my professor. And after the first tune, hearing Mr. Worth say his iconic line, "If you didn't like that one, you might as well go home now." Although I enjoyed that very much, there is no way I could have known the impact that this stage and this department would have on my future. Today, I am one of 285 music majors, which is the largest enrollment of music majors in the history of this university. Each one of us is here because somehow, some way, the music department here at Tamuk was the place that we chose to pursue both a life and career in music. For some of us, it all started with attending the jazz festival with our middle school jazz band, or high school jazz band like me. For others, it was seeing the Pride of South Texas Javelina Marching Band perform at their UIL Pigskin Marching Band Contest, or seeing the Kingsville Symphony Orchestra or Kingsville Chorale put on a live concert for the public. Now, here we are, performing on the same stages as those before us, and inspiring the next generation of music majors to come to this institution. However, inspiring the next generation of music majors does not come easy, and it would not be accomplished without the mentorship and guidance of the faculty here in the Tamworth Music Department. Our faculty is comprised of professional artists, performers, and educators who each and every day surround us with a treasure trove of wisdom, knowledge, and experience needed in order for this department to continue inspiring generations of music majors to come. I've always been fascinated by the idea that the student body here in the music department is comprised of students who are the leaders of the music programs from which they came. Once a student becomes a music major at this institution, they immediately become a part of this remarkable team of students, colleagues, and collaborators in a way that is unparalleled by any other activity. These same students, after graduating from this department, go on to become public school music teachers, administrators, band directors, university professors, and professional performers, not just in South Texas, but throughout the United States. I think it's safe to say that all these things collectively make the department here at TAMNUC serve as a safe haven for music education and performance here in South Texas. And that is the tradition. The new music building is simply a vessel that will aid and improve the continuation of this tradition in ways that we no longer have to dream of. I'd like to let you know how so. Having the largest enrollment of music majors in the history of this university sometimes poses some problems in our current facility. Anybody that's been to our music building in the last few years knows that it is packed in there. Like Dr. Hagman likes to say, we're 12 ounces of tuna in an 8-ounce can. Currently, there are roughly 15 practice rooms, 15, that all 285 of us have to share, which sometimes causes students to wait hours for a practice room or to even skip practicing entirely. Our new music building will have, wait for it, 50 practice rooms, offering plenty of practice space. Offering plenty of practice space and practice time for students. Our department also has over 25 regularly performing ensembles, yet there is only one actual rehearsal hall in our current facility, causing professors and students to use valuable rehearsal time to tear down and reset classroom setups or to trek over to another building in the sun or any other type of weather with equipment just to have a place to rehearse. Our new music building will have 4 large rehearsal halls and 3 smaller chamber rehearsal halls, along with the state-of-the-art technology that will provide our students and faculty with the convenience and tools necessary for a quality music-making environment. Yeah. However, there is more to this music building than just getting rid of the different day-to-day inconveniences. This new music building will provide current students, future students, and alumni with a sense of pride and will serve as a home for everything that this music department has achieved and everything that this music department deserves. I cannot wait to see what the future holds for this department and for this university. And again, I'd like to thank all of those who helped make this dream become a reality. On behalf of the Tamworth Music Department, here's to continuing the tradition.
And as we get from 3-2-1, then our marching band is going to play one last time. So, if you are ready, 3, 2, 1.